So now the first type of conjunction is coordinating conjunction, and it connects words, phrases and clauses. So a group of words is called phrases, and sentences are called clauses. So clauses are the sentences that contains a subject and predicate. So this way clauses is another word for sentences. We use them to place equal emphasis, means stress. So we are using these conjunction, coordinating conjunction, for laying equal stress, emphasis on two clauses, means two sentences. So when we look at the two examples given over here, I waited for you at the restaurant, but you did not come. So here, but is highlighted. So it is joining these two clauses, means these two independent sentences. In the second sentence, take these mangoes and distribute them among the children. So here and is joining the two independent clauses in this sentence. So when we look at further the clarification for this pertaining to this coordinating conjunction, we see that when we link clauses that have the same subject, we do not always need to repeat the subject in the second clause. So when we look at the sentence given, she did not shout or cry. So in this one, it is referring to the same subject, that is why she is not repeated in the sentence. So cry has been mentioned separately without, so since it is referring to the same subject, so it did not get repeated, it was not repeated. So now what is important here, what are the coordinating conjunctions? So there are seven coordinating conjunction. It is written over here: for, and, nor, but, or, yet, and so. So when we take the first letter from these conjunction from each, so it makes up a word, fanboys. So if we remember this word, it will be easy for us to remember all the seven conjunction that are called coordinating conjunction, and their function is to join words, phrases and clauses.